today's video, I will be showing you how to make a Northern Light tea light holder. So without any further ado, let's just head over to the wheel and get started again.
I start with throwing a pot. I first center the clay by pushing it to the middle of the wheel. I do this by coning it up and pushing it down. You can repeat this multiple times if necessary. Then I start opening it up by pushing with my right middle finger. I use my left hand to support my right one. Try to make the bottom as horizontal as possible. You can go over it multiple times if necessary. Then I start pulling up the clay. I do this by pushing with a sponge in my right hand towards my left hand on the inside, while moving my hands upwards. I repeat this multiple times. To prevent the cylinder from becoming too wide, I sometimes hold both of my hands around it and move them closer towards each other. While pulling up the walls, I hold the thumb of my left hand on my right hand. This helps me to move both of my hands at the same time. When I have the height that I want, I start to round the pot a bit. I do this by pushing from the inside out. I wanted the middle part of the pot to be straight, so I held a wooden loamer next to it and pressed the clay against it. You can of course make the pot any shape you'd like. After this, I bended the rim a bit more inwards. When I'm happy with the shape, I get rid of the water and slip that is on the piece. I do this by going over it with a sponge. Then I get rid of some excess clay at the bottom by cutting it away with a wooden knife. After the pot has dried for a day and it is leather hard, I start trimming it. To prevent the pot to fly off the wheel, I use a giving grip. I start off with flattening the bottom and make sure it is centered. Then I trim off some excess clay at the bottom part of the pot and give it a rounded shape. I also remove some clay out of the middle to create a foot. Then I smooth it out by going over it with a sponge. I remove the slip by going over it with a trimming tool that doesn't trim. And then smooth it out even more by going over it with my finger. Then the trimming is done. Over to making the holes. The first line of holes is the most difficult. It can be quite a challenge to get the holes in a straight line and to place them at the same distance from each other. You could measure it, but I prefer to do it by eye. What does help me to get the first line straight is the line you see in the clay between the part that you have and haven't trimmed. I keep this line at the bottom of the holes. After making the first line of holes, I add another line underneath. As you can see, I place them in between the holes above, so not straight underneath. And I also hold my hole maker the other way around. With the first line, I held the tip of the tool at the bottom, but I'm now holding it at the top. This makes it easier to place the holes in the right spot. Then I add another line of holes above the other line. You can of course make a lot of different patterns and just play with this. Here's a bit of a closer look to how exactly I made the holes. I place the tip of the tool onto the clay and then hold it horizontally and press it in while twisting it. And then I pull it straight out. So again, place the tool, push it in while twisting, and pull it straight out. As you can see, the clay gets stuck in the tool, so I take this out every time I make a hole. When I'm done with the third line, I move over to a smaller hole maker. You can use as many sizes of hole makers as you want. I prefer to only use two sizes. Otherwise you'd have to use a bigger size as well, which in my opinion can make the piece look less elegant. As you can see, the small hole maker leaves most of the holes in the piece. This isn't a problem, you can easily push them out later on. I make two lines of the smaller holes, and to make the pattern a bit more interesting, I make an extra hole straight underneath the previous hole. When I'm happy about the pattern, I push all of the little pieces of clay out of the holes. I place the piece upside down so the clay falls out of it and doesn't get stuck onto the bottom. I press the holes open with this tool. It has a little ball at the end, but you can basically use any tool you want. When all the holes are open, I use a wedge sponge to smooth out all of the holes. This is quite some work and very time consuming, but it will be worth it in the end. After going over the inside of a few holes, I go over them again, but more so on the outside. I do this to smooth out a little bit of clay that comes out of the holes. There may be some pieces of clay that stick out on the inside as well. It's quite hard to smooth this out with a sponge, so what I like to do is let the piece dry, and before putting it in the kiln for biscuit fire, go over it with your hand. The small pieces will easily break off and can get stuck because the clay is dry. After this, the piece is ready to be biscuitfired. Before I start glazing the piece, I like to put some painter's tape onto the bottom. I do this because I'm going to dip the piece. You could also use wax instead of the tape. I will be glazing the piece with the Northern Light glaze combination. I have a full instruction about this, but will explain it shortly. I start off with dipping the piece in obsidian from Emco. You could also brush it on. I would recommend to apply 3 coats. I first dip the bottom half. To get rid of some glaze at the bottom, I like to go over it with a brush. As you can see, the little holes get filled with glaze. I fix this by blowing them open with a straw. If you don't have a straw, you could also just blow, but you might have to blow a bit harder. When the bottom half has dried well enough for me to hold it, I dip the top part of the piece as well. As you can see, the bigger holes open by themselves. When the glaze has fully dried, I take off the tape from the bottom. Then I start applying the Northern Light colors. I start off with the color Indigo Float from Emco. I brush this onto the top part of the tea light holder. I apply 2 coats of every color. It's important to let the glaze dry in between layers. You can either wait for it to dry or use a heat gun to speed up the drying process. Then I apply a second layer of Indigo Float. The second color I apply is Smoky Mellow. I apply this onto the middle part of the piece. And as you can see, I brush it partly on top of the previous glaze. This will make the colors blend into each other. I also apply a second layer. And last but not least, I apply 2 coats of seaweed onto the bottom part of the piece. Before putting it in the kiln, I always clean the bottom by twisting it on top of a wet piece of fabric to get rid of the glaze that's still on there. And then the tea light holder is finished and ready to be fired. Here are some pictures of the final result.
That was it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked it and you learned something new from it. If so, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. And if you're going to make these tea light holders yourself and you're going to post them on Instagram, please tag me at @carlosceramic so that I can see your work, because I really enjoy that, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!